The answer is 0.55. So the key is zero. We can cancel that out. So we're left with delta M XOR with delta S. Well, that could be zero either if delta M is equal to zero and delta S is equal to zero. Then the XOR of zero and zero would be zero. The probability that delta M is zero, well, we know that. That's 0.61. And we're going to multiply that by the probability of delta S is zero, which we know is 0.73. But that's not the only way delta Z could be zero. The other way delta Z could be zero is if both of these are one. So it's the probability they're both zero plus the probability they're both one. And these probabilities are one minus the probabilities that we have before. So it's one minus 0.61 times one minus 0.73. And if you calculate all that, you get 0.5506. That's probably a little more precise than it should be, especially because this value is just a guess. We'd have to do a much more detailed analysis, German, to know whether that probability is really 0.61, and we'd have to know more about the particular messages that might be encrypted. But this value is pretty far away from a half. Any advantage that's that large, if we have a lot of text, we're going to see that pretty clearly. So if we have enough text, we can count the number of positions where delta Z is equal to zero. If it's close to half of them, well, then it was a wrong guess. If it's close to 0.55 of them, then we have a good likelihood that that was the right guess. So now all we have to do is feed in the intercepted messages. Our guesses for the starting position of the two keys, we need to compute a big summation of these values, of the delta Z values with those keys. And if it's close to the length of the message divided by 2, well, that means it was a bad guess. We weren't able to cancel out the key. If it's close to 0.55 times the size of Z, well, then it's a good key. It's likely that that's a good guess. And then we should be able to use those key guesses to find out what the actual message was to decrypt the ciphertext. So this is exactly the problem that what is arguably the first electronic digital computer was built to solve. So with this advantage, there's a good likelihood that you would be able to know when you guess the right key. You need to try all the configurations of K0 and K1. And for each one of those configurations, you have to compute this double delta. What we're computing for each configuration is this double delta, the XOR of two deltas. And that involves computing all these XORs. We need the XORs of the keys, XORed with the messages, and the S wheels. But remember, what we're doing is guessing that this is zero. We don't have any way to predict those S values. We're producing the key values, and we're XORing those key values with the intercepted ciphertext. So we need to do these XORs, XORing out the key, and XORing the key with the value of the ciphertext. So for each character, we're doing 7 XORs, and we're counting the number of times that's equal to zero. So multiplying all those together, we know the total number of XORs we need to do. So we get about 44.5 million. That's the maximum number that we might need to do. If we're lucky, we might get the right configuration right away, and we could know that that's the right configuration by getting the high number of zeros out. If we're unlucky, we might need all 1,271. Normally, we should expect to need about half of that. So maybe on average, we would need about 25 million XORs to find the configuration, the correct value of X, K1, and K0 for one ciphertext. Once we've got K1 and K0, well, we can do similar things to find K2, K3, and K4, and then we can decrypt the whole message. So today, modern processor runs at 2 gigahertz, so you're doing 2 billion operations per second. And one operation could include many XORs, possibly 64 XORs or 32 XORs, depending on your processor. So to do that on a modern processor would take a fraction of a millisecond. To do that in 1941 was a major technical challenge. Computers didn't exist yet, but this was the main impetus for building what was arguably the first electronic programmable digital computer.